Good morning. I wanted to make a little video this morning just to show you how, as teachers in a Waldorf kindergarten, we model drawing for young children. It's important to be mindful of their capacities and where they are and what they're capable of drawing and not make them feel too self-conscious. So we try not to draw a lot of form when we're modeling for them, especially anything that we really don't feel that they'd be capable of doing. Because when we do that, that can be intimidating and it sometimes shuts them down and they're not really willing to continue because they can't do that. So I'm gonna show you just a little exercise about kind of how that would look. So you set your child up for drawing. You maybe play or say the drawing verse for them. And then you begin modeling drawing. And usually, depending on what I'm going to draw, what I'm inspired to draw, will depend on how this unfolds. But I'm just going to do something basic that you can do anytime. So I would start by just kind of beginning with some grass. And just so you know, the story prompts that we gave you, the little drawing verses, you don't have to draw what's in those verses, and neither does the child. But you can. They're just there to sort of spark the imagination. So I will go slowly. Now your child is going to move a lot quicker than you in their drawing, and if they glance at you, you're really just, this is quite boring. I'm just making green. And I try not to have a lot of conversation with them about what I'm doing. So if they say, "What are you doing?" I say, "I'm doing my drawing." And I'm going a little quicker maybe just for you so you don't have to be watching me for too long than I would for them. But I start out with like a light green for the grass. I don't go straight for the dark green. And your children have these colors in their crayon box too. They might be willing to share with you if you ask nicely. So I'll start out with some grass, and if I want to make some hills, I can, but I'm going to leave space if I want to draw a person. And if you do want to draw a person, I want to show you the way we would do that. So I'm going to take yellow, and I'm going to start with just the head, and I'm not drawing, you'll notice I'm going to do this on the side, I'm not making a circle with a hard line and then filling it in. I'm really creating a circle without a defined line on the outside of yellow for the head. And then I'm taking that and I'm creating a body. And I would only draw a person while your child's drawing if your child can already draw a threefold person, a head, a body, and legs. If your child cannot do that yet, I would just put color on the page. So I'm creating some arms that are just coming off, trying to just fill them in. Again, you don't have to be a perfect artist. And then I'm creating the legs that come down and the feet. Like a threefold person. So this is the beginning of a person that you would draw in front of your child. And then if you wanted to put clothing on, like I will give this little fella a red shirt, you go right over the yellow. We do a lot of layering of colors to give it depth and life. And you can put this golden yellow under most things that you draw, and it will actually brighten up and give the drawing some life. And I'm going to give this one some brown pants. But again, if your child is not yet drawing limbs and a body and a head, you would not do that either. You really watch their drawings and they dictate to you what they're ready for. I can add some hair. And we don't need details. They don't need eyes, nose, mouth, face. The children might put that on theirs, but you don't need to put that on yours. So after I draw my child, if I want any other elements that I need, such as a tree, I may add that in as well. Before I bring the sky and the earth together. And I take a good amount of time on this so that they can take the time on theirs. And if I want to make this trunk have some depth, I add yellow over my brown. And then I always start with the lightest shade first. So for my tree, which you're welcome to make any kind of tree you want. Children make all sorts of trees. I'm being quick for you. And I typically will draw a pretty similar picture almost each time that we're doing drawing time, unless I feel like adding another element in. And sometimes I don't even have the opportunity to finish before they are finished. And it's really not about my drawing or whether I'm finished. It's just that I'm modeling and being focused and teaching my child how to do that when they're doing their work. Because in kindergarten, that's what we're practicing. Taking time in certain moments to sit and do a task, complete a task. So I will put a sun and then I will create the sky and make sure I'm filling the page so my sky meets the ground. That's what we're hoping the child does one day in kindergarten, is one day when they're ready, their sky will meet the ground. And I will layer other colors in here to bring a little bit more life and depth to it. And very carefully go around my people, my person. Again, you can go even slower. I'm doing this because you may not want to sit and watch me draw all day long. And then, to read if that's the right color, I'll kind of, on the edges, I'm adding a little bit of purples to my sky. Bring some depth. That's just some perhaps purpleness in the background here. Maybe there's some mountains back there. And then the only details, if you wanted to add detail to your picture, would be to add a few nature details, like very simple flowers or birds and animals. But really, we don't want to distract the child from their imagination and their work. So this is really just the basic way that you could draw when modeling with your child. Simple and really nothing that would intimidate them in their own work. So thanks for listening. I hope you enjoy the rest of your time drawing together.